You're here to learn about Google Ads display campaigns in 2020. I'm here to teach you about Google Ads campaigns in 2020. And this year, we are going to kill it together with Google Ads display campaigns. Hi, I'm Sam Fields from Matter Solutions, and today we're going to go through how to make a successful Google Ads display campaign. So what is a display campaign? Well, for starters, Google has two networks, the search network and the display network. We've discussed search campaigns in the past. You'll find out more here, but essentially a search campaign is when you're advertising to someone who's searching on Google for your product or service. The display network does run on a cost per click basis. There is some other variations like cost per million impressions and that sort of thing. We will be exploring that later on, but for now, we're just going to focus on the CPC element. The network uses images, videos, text, and GIFs across a multitude of Google partner sites in order to show your ad to the people that you're targeting in your account. In fact, as long as you don't have an ad blocker, which you shouldn't, then I'd wager that you have actually seen a number of Google Ads display ads today. They come in all shapes and sizes, and as you can see, we've created a number of them for our digital workshop, and you can see them on the screen now. My recommendation will be to try out every single shape, size, and format in order to get the right data in to make the best decisions based off that data. Because we're feeling generous, we've decided to put a full list of the sizes and formats in the description below, so check it out. Now, the first display campaign targeting that I use is remarketing, and it's also my favorite. Why is remarketing my favorite, I hear you ask? One of the main reasons why I like remarketing is you're getting a second bite of the pie when it comes to people coming to your site. And there's a reason why remarketing actually has a very high conversion rate. And that's because people have come to your site, they've seen your brand, they know who you are, they know what your product or service is, and maybe previously they weren't too sure if they were gonna buy, but now they are, and so they click on your ad, or alternatively, it could be that they just weren't able to buy at the time, or they're doing their due diligence. There's a number of things you can actually do to the remarketing targeting that will help you improve the performance of your remarketing campaign. And that includes targeting things like specific URLs with specific product or messaging in order to maximize the conversions that are coming through the campaign. Another type of targeting in display ads campaigns is in-market audiences. This audience is based on when someone is actively planning or researching for an event or something in the future, such as a baby or buying a house or even buying a car. This is why people think that Google is listening to them sometimes. Basically, Google has mapped out certain behaviors and is showing you ads that react to those behaviors. For example, if you're looking for a cot or a crib, well, Google will know that very soon you're going to be looking for nappies or diapers. I like to test these out as my secondary display ads targeting. And the reason being is because these people often have a high intent because they're actively researching and planning for that product. I'll just interject on myself here quickly. I've said that this is my secondary strategy, but in reality, it is a case-by-case basis. And the reason why I say this is because depending on what type of business you are, an affinity audience may be better for your secondary strategy. What is an affinity audience? Well, I'll get to that in a moment, but first hit like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. We've noticed, as I said last time, that 90% of you out there aren't subscribed to this channel, and you're watching this video for free, so help us out. Hit that subscribe button and let me know in the comments below what you think. So affinity audiences are based off the interests and the habits of the people, as opposed to the in-market audience, which is based off what they are actively researching and planning at the present. An example would be the ability to advertise to someone who loves watching sport or loves to travel, or basically a variety of other interests that you can actually define in the Google Ads display campaign. It's It's actually really cool. Say that you sell NBA jerseys. You can target people whose Google Ads account activity is showing that they are basketball fans. How cool is that? I'd recommend split testing affinity audiences and in-market audiences in order to get the best results. Keep in mind that you can actually layer the different targetings on your audiences. So this allows you further refinement tools that will mean that you can target the people that are most likely to buy. Furthermore, you can actually find out after your campaigns have been running for a while, where your ads are performing the best in the display network. And what this means is that you can actually exclude places where your ads aren't working and bid more aggressively on the positions where it is working. And another layer that you can put across all of your targeting is demographics like age, gender, household income, depending on where you are in the world. In the coming weeks, we'll obviously be exploring in depth a variety of topics such as retargeting / remarketing across a variety of platforms, as well as YouTube campaigns, among a number of other things. So stick around